Welcome back. A major story hitting headlines recently has been an accident involving the luxury car Lamborghini. The young businessman driving it lost control and was killed, while the cyclist he hit is now paralyzed. It seems it's not an isolated case, because there have been at least 4 such incidents involving luxury cars in just the last 6 months. Alok Pandey has a story.
It is an uphill battle for 45-year-old Kishan Lal and his family at the All India Institute of Medical Sciences Trauma Center. On Sunday morning, a young South Delhi businessman was zooming in his Lamborghini car. He lost control and the car hit Kishan Lal, who was cycling his way to work. The businessman Anukul Rishi is dead. Kishan Lal is at the intensive care unit at this hospital with severe fractures and partial paralysis.
My mom is very upset at this time. My brother is very frustrated. We are very frustrated at this time. I can't say anything. I have taken the operation theater.
The Lamborghini case is not an isolated one, unfortunately. Across Delhi, there are many other instances of those killed by people speeding in these fast and expensive cars, and of families who are yet to overcome the trauma of losing their loved ones. One such family lives here in these congested bylanes of Delhi's Pahadganj area. On the 7th of January this year, a drunk 24-year-old Harshneet Marwa was speeding in his Mercedes at 2:30 a.m. in the morning in South Delhi's Vasant Kunj area, when he hit an auto rickshaw. Lalit Kumar Ojha was killed on the spot. His wife Raj Lakshmi is now single-handedly trying to manage the household, including her 2 small sons.
से तो आता है क्योंकि इसलिए गुस्सा आता है कि उन लोगों को आगे दिख के नहीं चलते कि जैसे वो सोचते आगे वाले जो हैं मक्खी जैसे हैं.
Harshneet Marwa is now out on bail. He and his family live here at this posh South Delhi locality. We tried getting in touch with Harshneet, but the family members who spoke to us off camera refused to tell us where he is at the moment.
I think the law also need to be strict with this one. See, the whole city should know that the upper limit for driving in the city is 70 kilometers. And for these vehicles, 70 kilometers is absolutely nothing.
But with as many as 4 incidents involving these cars in the last 6 months alone, it seems that not too many people are paying attention to speed limits. Showrooms for these cars refuse to divulge information about their sales, but told NDTV they try and conduct workshops for car owners or enthusiasts. But till rules are followed and speed limits adhered to, more and more people may fall victim in such cases. With Tonima Bishwas and camera person Alfred Monsan, Alok Pandey, NDTV.
So is there a problem with the luxury cars? Because a lot has been talked about the Lamborghinis, BMWs, other cars that have been involved in these accidents. Or is it the fact that we have lax laws and the people are responsible? They're just irresponsible people driving it. Let's just get to our guest. We have Satyendra Garg. He's a joint commissioner of traffic police. We have Majid Memon, a famous lawyer. He's been involved in a lot of these cases. He's presented case. Rohit Baluja, of the president of the Institute of Traffic Education, and auto expert Orma Sorabji. Satyendra Garg, if I can just start with you. What has come out is that, you know, there have been so many incidents. In fact, that report itself showed in last 6 months, we've seen at least 4 such incidents. And in Bombay as well, we see a lot of them. What's wrong? Is it a problem with these, or is it the users of such luxury cars who have a reckless attitude?
See, basically, if you see the, once we are talking about last 6 months, yeah, like basically what happens, this is like what we have come to know, like basically in the night, like when roads are comparatively empty and you have got a very powerful vehicle, and when you hit the road, basically like maybe you have a tendency to overspeed. And that's where what is happening, like this BRT corridor accident, like around 5:30, like you have got a very powerful vehicle, and maybe like what people say, like we don't have the exact estimate, like you are hitting say 150 kilometer per hour, and maybe in that corridor, like sometime, like you have got curves, you have got bus stops and all this thing.
And this young businessman may have been drinking.
See, officially that is not confirmed, but the impression could be that yeah, it could be like it could be like generally like these things go together. Like you drink, then you drive very fast, and sometimes you end up in an accident where like you are hurt, or like this one, or sometimes others pay the price.
Okay, Marjit, I mean, you have seen a lot of these cases in Bombay. You were telling me just half a dozen cases in Mumbai involving all these fancy cars. Where do you see the problem?
You see, for the, I think during the past couple of years, if not just 6 months, I would say that these offenses of hit and run and, you know, killing on the streets by these modern vehicles which are just, you know, running with the high pace has been so common, and people by and large feel that the law seems to be ineffective to deter such riders, you know, who not only endanger themselves, you know, exposing themselves to serious accidents, but also not caring for less fortunate people who are either walking on the streets, sleeping on the pavements, or traveling in some lesser developed
So you're saying it's attitude of the people?
Absolutely. I think there's a need for a bit of education in the society. See, rich people are in a position to have very high-flying vehicles. You know, just press this accelerator and go on flying and enjoy. You know, you are not supposed to drive the these kinds of sports vehicles or luxury vehicles on busy streets.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone, fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.